Hi, this is part 5 of compression and decompression. So in this we are going to see CCITT group 3 2D compression. Previous it was 1D compression. This is 2D compression. So this is also called modified run length encoding, software based. Here the compression ratio averages from 10 to 20. So it combines both 1D and 2D schemes. So 2D encoding gives higher compression because it considers lines, multiple lines, right? So the difference is only little from the above and below lines. So this uses a K factor where images are divided into several groups of K lines. So that is why it uses something called a K factor. The scheme is based on statistical nature of images, as the images data crosses the adjacent scan line is redundant. So we saw something called busy image. So similar to that, here the scheme is based on the statistical nature of the images because the image data across the adjacent scan line is redundant. If black and white transition occurs on a given scan line, chances are that the same transition will occur within plus or minus 3 pixels in the next scan line. So based on this, we are going for this compression technique. We have the K factor here. So necessity for your K factor. So 2D compression embeds 1D encoding between every K groups. We have actually divided the image into K groups. So now what happens? 1D encoding is embedded within every K group. Okay. So this allows the group 3 1D coding to be synchronizing the line in the event of transmission error. So here is where your error correction comes. So if that is, it doesn't allow the error to be transmitted. Previously we didn't have any error things. That was a disadvantage. So therefore, when a transmission error occurs due to bad communication link, the group 1D can be used to synchronize and correct the error. Okay. So this error protection, now only we are coming to the error protection. It is used in fax. Okay. So in disk-based applications, K factor, it is set to infinito because they say storage and retrieval is reliable on the disks. Next, data formatting. How does it go about? The first line of each K group is encoded using 1D and it is set as the reference line for the rest of the lines in the group. So first line is set as the reference line. The 2D scheme uses a combination of additional codes called vertical code, pass code, horizontal code to encode every line in the group of K lines, right? So not only the first line is reference line, we use vertical code, pass code and horizontal code for every line in this group of K lines. So the pass code will have only one value. Similarly, horizontal code will have only one value. There are 7 types of vertical codes, right? So what is this? The values depend on the position difference between the changing pixels in the reference line and the changing pixel in the encoding line. So you have a reference line and you have an encoding line. So what is the value position? What is the difference? So this difference makes the values. Depending on the values, we have the changing pixels. So this is how it is. What is the vertical code? If the changing pixel value is there, what is the vertical code? This is how it goes. Then steps for pseudocode to code the code line. So how do you go about it? So parse the coding line and look for the change in the pixel value. So you have the coding line, you check with the reference line. If the value is same, not same, how it is right, right? So what is the change? So change is found at A1 location, right? Change will be found at A1 location. Now parse the reference line and look for the change in pixel. So now sometimes you may find change at B1 location. Now find the difference. This is how you say delta is B1 minus A1. This is A1 is in the coding line. B1 is in the reference line. What is the change? Now find the difference. So that's how it happens. So what is the advantage of this? Implementation of K factor allows error-free transmission. Compression ratio is better than 1D of the same CC1 group 3. and it is accepted for document imaging applications. Disadvantage: it doesn't provide dense compression. It's complex and relatively difficult to implement in software. Next, group 4 2D compression. A 2D coding scheme without a K factor. We used a K factor. Now here there is no K factor. Here the first line is the reference line, but it is an imaginary line. Okay, it is all white line. So we had a original line, first line as a reference line in the previous one. Here it is all white line. It's only an imaginary line. It is the above the top of the image. It is considered to be above the top of the image. Then the first group of pixels is encoded utilizing this imaginary white line as reference line, right? So all the groups pixels, they are encoded based on the imaginary line. So the new coded line now becomes the reference for the next scan line. So you have one reference line, you code one line. Now that coded line becomes the reference line for the next line, and it goes on like that. So the K factor in this case is the entire page of the line. Okay, so you are not considering K factor. Even if you want to consider, it is the entire page. So this gives a high level of compression. So there are no reference lines, right? So a single error can result in the rest of the page being skewed. That is again a disadvantage. So data format for this compression. In this matter, there is no end of line, EOL markers before the start of the compressed data. Okay, filters are not used either for scan line or at the file. Compressed image starts and ends at byte boundaries. So you have byte boundaries, you have starting and ending of the image at byte boundaries. So this is how it has. So what you do? Data line 1, 2, 3, this is how it has, and you have two end of line files. Previously you saw end of file in the middle. Now it is not there. So you have just two end of line and you have pad bits. So end of the page consists of two concatenated EOLs. This is the page. It has two concatenated EOLs with padding bits added immediately after the compressed data. These are the pad bits. Pad bits, number of bits depends upon us, the user. Right? So this is how it happens. Thank you.